Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about nitrogen metabolism. Now the topic which comes under nitrogen metabolism are molecular mechanism of nitrogen fixation, assimilation of nitrate and ammonium, biosynthesis of amino acids. Now why do plants need nitrogen? Nitrogen is an essential component of DNA, RNA and protein, the building blocks of life. Although the majority of air we breathe is nitrogen, the most living organisms are unable to use the nitrogen as it exists in atmosphere. So, what is molecular mechanism of nitrogen fixation? Nitrogen fixation is a process that causes strong two-atom nitrogen molecule found in the atmosphere to break apart so that they can combine with other atom. These nitrogen get fixed when it combines with oxygen or hydrogen. The atmospheric nitrogen is converted into ammonia or nitrate. When the atmospheric nitrogen combines with the hydrogen, it makes ammonia. In the same way, when this atmospheric nitrogen combines with the oxygen, it form a nitrate. So these form a nitrate. So these form of nitrogen can be utilized by the plants. There are three ways to fix nitrogen. One is atmospheric fixation, another one is industrial fixation, third is the biological fixation. In case of nitrogen fixation, industrial fixation, under great pressure at the temperature of 600 degrees Celsius and with the use of a catalyst, atmospheric nitrogen and the hydrogen are combined to form ammonia. Now this ammonia can be used as a fertilizer. In case of atmospheric nitrogen fixation, lightning helps in fixing the nitrogen. Only 5 to 8% of fixation process takes place here. Here, the enormous energy of lightning breaks the nitrogen molecule apart and able the nitrogen atom to combine with oxygen, forming nitrogen oxide. This nitrogen oxide dissolve in rain, forming nitrates. These nitrates are carried out to the ground with the rainwater. Last one is the biological fixation, which was done by diazotrophs. Here the most of the nitrogen, which is atmospheric nitrogen, will be get fixed. There are two types. One is through free living bacteria, nitrogen will be fixed, and another one is symbiotic association bacteria will help in fixing the nitrogen. It fixes about 30% of atmospheric nitrogen, and they are highly specialized bacteria which lives in the soil and have a ability to combine atmospheric nitrogen with the hydrogen and make ammonia. Some of the examples of nitrogen fixing bacteria are obligate anaerobe, such as Clostridium species, facultative anaerobe, that is Klebsiella species, photosynthetic bacteria, Rhodobacter species, and many cyanobacteria like Nostoc, obligate aerobe such as Azotobacter, and some methanogens. Since usually the nitrogenase enzymes helps in converting the nitrogen into ammonium. Since this nitrogenase is inactivated by oxygen, the fixation of nitrogen must be taken under the condition where anaerobic is at least locally. For anaerobes, there is no problem. Facultative organisms such as purple photosynthetic bacteria or Klebsiella species fix nitrogen only when anaerobic situation is present. Other organisms have a protective mechanism. In case of cyanobacteria, the oxygen is actually generated by photosynthesis. So the fixation of nitrogen will occur in a special cell known as heterocyst, which do not photosynthesize but are devoted solely for nitrogen fixation. 70% of atmospheric nitrogen will be fixed by symbiotic bacteria. Here, what happens is that bacteria lives in the root of the legume family plant and provide the plant with ammonium in exchange for the plant's carbon and protected home.
If we take this as a root hair of a legume plant, this root hair will consist of a lectin, which is a carbohydrate protein which acts as a receptor in the plant root cells. Now, these receptors were detected by the free living rhizobium which is present on the soil, and they will try to attach this receptor with the help of their protein called polygalacturonidase. Then this rhizobium, after infection, it will start to invade the root hair cells. There the plant will detect this infection and start to produce indole acetic acid, which is an auxin that lead to the curling of the root hair. Then the infection thread will penetrate inside the cortex of the root hair, causing them to divide. Once this bacteria enters into the cortex cell, what happens is that they will start to divide faster. This will lead to the formation of a bacterioid which enter into the plant cell membrane, and they utilize this plant cell membrane and cover themselves with another protective layer called peribacterioid membrane. So inside this, bacterial cells will be there which are rapidly dividing. So once this bacterioid formed along with the peribacterioid membrane, they will start to produce cytokines which lead to the crown gall formation in the roots. Now if we take this as a plant root cell, inside the plant cytoplasm there will be a bacterioid, and this bacterioid will have a vacuole which is produced by the plant by utilizing plant membrane called as peribacterioid membrane. Here inside the bacterioid, conversion of nitrogen into ammonia takes place with the help of a nitrogenase enzyme. As I told earlier, the nitrogen is sensitive to oxygen. So to control the oxygen in the plant cell, what happens is that plant will produce a leg hemoglobin protein. So to produce this leg hemoglobin protein, plant will first produce a globin protein, and heme will be produced by the bacterioid. So combining with these two proteins, they form a leg hemoglobin. This leg hemoglobin will attach with the oxygen and remove the oxygen from the bacterioid, so that the conversion of nitrogen into ammonia takes place with the help of a nitrogenase enzyme. But this conversion of nitrogen into ammonia will not, like this process is not needed in all the time, because this reaction is a energy consuming reaction, and all the time the plant doesn't require this ammonia, like nitrogen, to be converted into ammonium. So what happens is that this reaction will be controlled by carbon monoxide which is present in the plant cell cytoplasm. What this carbon monoxide will do is that it will go and bind to the leg hemoglobin, so that it can't able to bind with the oxygen, due to which the oxygen level will be increased. This oxygen, increased level of oxygen will come and bind to the nitrogenase enzyme, which degrade this enzyme. That will lead to the conversion, that will block the conversion of nitrogen into ammonium. So this carbon monoxide will block both leg hemoglobin as well as nitrogenase enzyme activity. But whenever the plant require the conversion of nitrogen into ammonium, it will signal the bacterioid, so that the bacteria will take up this carbon monoxide and convert into carbon dioxide with the help of an enzyme, carbon monoxide dehydrogenase, so that there will be a decrease in carbon monoxide concentration in the plant cell. This will lead to the increase in leg hemoglobin absorption of oxygen, that will lead to the conversion of nitrogen into ammonium, because this nitrogenase enzyme will not be degraded or inactivated by the oxygen. So in this way, the nitrogen will be converted into ammonium. This ammonium will be utilized by the plant for the synthesis of the food. Now this is the picture of a rhizobium bacterioid performing symbiotic nitrogen fixation. Here the nitrogen will be converted into ammonia. Now this ammonium will be utilized for the production of amino acid like aspartate, glutamate, and this amino acid will be transferred to the plant. Now the plant in turn will provide succinate, fumarate and malate. This will be utilized for the production of heme. As I told, this heme will be utilized for the production of leghemoglobin, which combines with the, like this heme will combine with the globulin protein which was provided by the plant to form leghemoglobin. So in this way, the rhizobium bacterioid perform the symbiotic nitrogen fixation. Now this nitrogenase complex has two components. One is component 1 and another one is component 2. The component 1 is molybdopyridoxine, whereas the component 2 is azopyridoxine. Now this molybdopyridoxine is a alpha beta subunit, which is a tetramer. The alpha and beta subunit are similar but distinct and are encoded by NIF-K and NIF-D genes. Each tetramer contains two molybdenum and several ferrosulfate group. Whereas in case of azopyridoxine, it is a dimer of identical subunit by NIF-H and contain single ferrosulfate group, Fe4S4 group per dimer. Now this is the diagrammatic representation of NIF genes in Klebsiella pneumoniae. Now for the biosynthesis of amino acid, 1 nitrogen plus 8 hydrogen plus 8 electron plus 16 ATP will be utilized for the synthesis of 2 ammonia plus 1 hydrogen and 16 ADP plus 16 PI will be produced. So here, as I told, the NIF genes which involved in the production of conversion of nitrogen into ammonia, these are the component 1 and this is component 2, where the pyruvate plus carbon dioxide will be converted into acetyl CoA plus carbon dioxide, and NIFH will utilize 2 ATP to be converted into 2 ADP plus 2I. That will convert 1 nitrogen into ammonia. This process will be takes place like 8 times will be this process, that this reaction will takes place to produce or to convert nitrogen into ammonia. So this ammonia will be utilized for the synthesis of amino acid like glutamate, which will be converted into glutamine. Now this glutamine either will be converted into aspartate or ketoglutarate, which further converted into oxaloacetate and aspartate, whereas this aspartate will be converted into aspergine. So in this way, these amino acids will be produced by utilizing this ammonium. Next process is nitrogen assimilation. Here the conversion of nitrate into a high energy form nitrate and then to a yet another high energy form ammonium and finally into a amide nitrogen of glutamine. The process consume about equivalent to about 12 ATP per nitrogen. The nitrate absorbed by the roots and assimilated into organic nitrogen compound by the plant. And to this reaction, the reduction of nitrate into a nitrite in the cytosol with the help of an enzyme nitrate reductase. Here, one molecule of nitrate will combine with NADPH plus H plus ion plus a 2 molecule of electrons. These will give rise to nitrite and NADP plus 1 molecule of water. In case of a nitrate reductase, it is a dimer. It consists of 3 subunits. One is FAD, and a heme group and a molybdenum complex. The molybdenum deficiency, the nitrate reductase is mainly molybdenum containing protein in vegetative tissue. The molybdenum deficiency will diminish the nitrate reductase activity, which will lead to the accumulation of nitrate. Nitrate, light and carbohydrate regulate nitrate reductase. Nitrate, light and carbohydrate influence the nitrate reductase at the transcription and translation level. The nitrate is highly reactive and potential toxic ion, so the plant cell immediately transport the nitrite generated by nitrate from the cytoplasm into the chloroplast in leaves and plastids in roots. Nitrate reductase. The enzyme nitrate reductase reduces the nitrite to ammonium according to the following reaction, in which the nitrate plus 6 FAD redox plus 8 hydrogen atom plus 6 electron will be utilized for will be converted into ammonia plus 6 FAD oxidized plus 2 water molecule with the help of an enzyme nitrate reductase. Now this is the model for the coupling of photosynthetic electron flow via ferredoxime to a reduction of nitrate by nitrate reductase. The enzyme contains two prosthetic group, that is iron sulfur cluster and a heme, which participate in reduction of nitrate to ammonium. Finally, the nitrogen cycle. In atmosphere, the nitrogen will be fixed by lightning, where it is converted into nitrates. These nitrates were assimilation, nitrates were fixed by the plant through assimilation. These plants were consumed by the animal. When both these plants and animal were died, they were decomposed by aerobic and anaerobic bacteria and fungi. Later, ammonification takes place, which produces ammonium. This ammonium will be converted into nitrates through nitrifying bacteria. Now, these nitrates are converted into nitrites will be converted into nitrates through nitrifying bacteria. Again, these nitrates were consumed or fixed by the assimilation of the legume plants. So, this cycle will continue.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.